Maybe the especially for others who think that God doesn't care. That reminds me of the apostles in the boat, the storm, and they waited, asking, don't you care? And he replies, why is your faith so weak? When folks feel that God doesn't care, their faith is weak. And they need someone like you who can understand. Faith, not evidence, but it's a kind of certitude that includes a restlessness and inquietude. But that's what makes faith such a marvelous bridge to the journey, because you are giving so much to him. Might I want you to know that it ought to be said often that we priests are happy in our priesthood. I'm glad that I'm a priest. I'm happy. I'm glad that hands were laid on me. Hey, I may not always live it like I should, but with his help, I'm watching. I can't imagine myself being anything else. The priesthood for me is like water to the fish or sky. My father was a grocer, my mother was a nurse, but I feel I was born to be a priest. I hope that your priesthood will be even more so and be even more good than my own, because then I will know that you are an happy priest, or whatever the site, or whatever the price. And I hope that often in your life that you speak to others about the joy of being a priest. Might I wish you simplicity of life, prayerfulness, sacrifice. I wish you humility and generosity, all things that in your priestly life will bring you joy and peace, not as the world gives you, but as God gives you. My son, before you proceed to the order of the presbyter, declare before the people your intention to undertake this priestly office. Are you resolved, with the help of the Holy Spirit, to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral order as a conscientious fellow worker with the bishops and caring for the Lord's flock? Are you resolved to celebrate the mysteries of Christ faithfully and religiously as the Church has handed them down to us for the glory of God and the sanctification of Christ's people? Are you resolved to exercise the ministry of the Word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and explaining the Catholic faith? Are you resolved to consecrate your life to God for the salvation of his people and to unite yourself more closely every day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a perfect sacrifice? Do you promise respect and obedience to your Lord? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to you. My dear people, let us pray that the all-powerful Father may pour out the gifts of heaven on this servant of his whom he has chosen to be priest. Come to our help, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. You are the source of every honor and dignity, of all progress and stability. You watch over the growing family of man by your gift of wisdom and your pattern of order. When you had appointed high priests to rule your people, you chose other men next to them in rank and dignity to be with them and to help them in their task. So there grew up the ranks of priests and the offices of Levites established by sacred rites. In the desert, you extended the spirit of Moses to 70 wise men who helped him to rule the great company of his people. You shared among the sons of Aaron the fullness of their father's power to provide worthy priests a sufficient number for the increasing rites of sacrifice and worship. With the same loving care, you gave companions to your sons and apostles to help in teaching the faith that they preach the gospel to the whole world. Lord, grant also to us such fellow workers, for we are weak and our
I want this.